All right, so this is obviously going to be a YouTube video. So you're going to see YouTube Crip here. Okay, YouTube Crip's coming. All right. Hey, guys, how's it going? Criparian here. Got yourselves a live card review on stream, which you're now watching on a YouTube VOD, probably. So we're going to do things a little bit differently this time. We are going to look at cards in the perspective of the game that we'll probably play, which is generally duels and to a lesser degree constructed. Just to quickly go through some cards, get some understanding about what's happening in the next expansion without going into too much detail on, honestly, a lot of the cards that we won't see too much of. An efficient card review, if you may. Let's do it by class. Starting with Demon Hunter, lifesteal, deal 1 damage to a minion and its neighbors. Any kind of lifesteal spell is going to be pretty good, because when you're making a duels deck, you kind of want to, you know, push the idea that you might be playing a spell deck, and anything with lifesteal can be pretty good. Why not? Throw Glaive, deals 2 damage. If it dies, you get another one of these. So it's kind of like Echo, but it's not really Echo. And the important thing of it not being Echo is that if you're playing duels and you have the -1 mana cost per spell, this will cost 0 every single time. Echo cards can't go to 0 anymore. They nerfed Echo cards, okay? So this card is like built for duels. If you get the spell discount by 1 treasure, you're in business. No, not Echo. Echo, but not Echo, which is much better. Redeemed Pariah, after you play an outcast card, gain +1/+1. It's 2 for a 2/3, so it's not bad stats. Outcast is not too heavily played in duels. It is played pretty often in constructed, so probably some constructed action. In duels, I feel like they will have to have some kind of starting treasure or starting hero power that works with outcast for it to actually see play, but I imagine they're going to do that because it's one of the main things for Demon Hunter. Just don't know if we'll get that on launch day or not. Acrobatics, draw 2, and if you play them both, draw 2 more. So it can be like a sprint for 3 mana, which is crazy. Any kind of super aggressive Demon Hunter deck is going to want to play this, and, well, that's basically all of them. So that's really good. 5 stars! Alright, Dreadlord Bite, 3 for 3/2. Outcast, deal 1 all enemies. Obviously a strong card. So it's like a good card. Yeah, they're going to play it in Constructed because it's a clear. They're going to play it in Duels because it's a pretty good weapon. But what you don't see here is if you're playing Duels, you know how like those Demon Hunters like never, ever, 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 ever die because they have that lifesteal weapon and they have another lifesteal weapon and they have another lifesteal weapon and they have another lifesteal weapon? So because this is, for one, a weapon, and two, a 3-mana weapon, so if you have like the treasure that refreshes your weapon when you lose your weapon, okay, basically there's going to be less lifesteal weapons offered if you're playing duels Demon Hunter. So this is a really good card, but this actually soft nerfs lifesteal weapon Demon Hunter spell-based deck, all that shit. All right. Linehopper, 3/3/4, outcast costs 1 less. Again, probably pretty good in the outcast package, but probably going to be constructed only until we see some kind of treasure or starting hero powers that work with outcast. Relentless Pursuit, 4 attack and immune. I think this card is not very good. Fellhound, 3 for a 2/5 taunt and corrupt, gain +1/+1 and lifesteal. This is a big one. Corrupt, if you haven't caught it, is you basically play something that costs more than the card and it has to be in your hand. So if this is sitting in your hand and you play like a 4-cost card, this will be a 3-cost, 3/6 taunt lifesteal. What the hell? It's insane, right? So I think it's a pretty good card. I think we might actually see it in dual starter decks because it's kind of a struggle to put demons that don't blow. And I think this is pretty good. Any kind of taunt card is pretty good in honestly every game mode. So, yep, pretty good. Fellsteel Executioner, 3/4/4/3, and the corrupt becomes a weapon. So you get a 4/3 weapon for 3. I guess that's cool. I don't know. Yeah, that's a ton of face damage. You gotta corrupt it. Thing is, a lot of weapon-based decks don't run cards over 4 or over 3 in this case, so I don't know if it'll be that easy to make a deck that utilizes this, but it's a really good card if you can activate it regularly. Zai is a legendary. You copy both left and rightmost cards on the Battlecry, so it's like it's worse than draw two because your opponent will know what those cards, so they'll be able to like anticipate them. But it's better than draw two if you're playing like combo type decks, because you might be able to actually have crazy as shit OTK combos that otherwise didn't exist. So if it is draw two, and I think it's maybe a little bit better than draw two, but let's say it is draw two, 5/5/3 draw two, that's a pretty good card. Bladed Lady, it's 6/6/6 rush, but you'd only really play it if you can regularly get a weapon with 6 or more attack. In Constructed, this isn't that hard to do, but Constructed, I don't know if like that hard to do is really good enough to play this card. So I don't know if it's going to be like super good in Constructed. It might not be played at all. But in Duels, it's really easy to get 6 attack. Like literally any deck can get 6 attack. So this card is insane in Duels. This card's straight crazy. I think you'll see this in every starter deck. You also have to keep in mind, it's a demon. So if you use that, like, draw 3 demons from your deck starting treasure, yeah. Wow. Stilt Stepper, 3/4/4/1, draw card. If you play it this turn, give your hero +4 attack. So, yep, pretty good. Actually, it's broken. The more I look at it, it's broken, right? It's broken. Because it's 3/4/4/1 draw card, which is like okay, right? That's not bad. If you like cut the text off there, that's not bad. And then you play the thing and you get 4 attack. That's insane. I don't know if I'd say 5-star because I don't know if we'll see playing Constructed, but it looks really good. The other legendary, 4/2/6 lifesteal. Your lifesteal damages the enemy hero instead of healing you. For Constructed, this is probably very good. For Duels, it might break the game. This might break the game, guys. This card is not fair. Because, like, those Demon Hunters who have, like, a 20 attack weapon because of twin slices off the hero power, they hit you for 20, and then the lifesteal hits you for another 20. And then you're dead. So this card is, like, 5-stars, easy peasy. Renowned Performer. Rush 3/3/4, and the Death Rattle summons 2 assistants with taunt. I mean, that's okay, right? That's pretty good. Yep, pretty good, pretty good. Cantrips stuff. Probably not going to be played too much. Pretty good. Expendable Performers. Summon 7/1/1s with Rush, and if they all die, you get 7 more. 14/1/1s. So, like, this would be like maybe a good card if you're not playing a deck with like any minions, right? Then it would be pretty good. It'd also be pretty good if you're playing like Duels and you already have the Poison Treasure, but that's about it. All right, next up, Druid. What's Druid getting? Fair Arborist, 3/2/2, draw card, or you get a 2/2, either one. Like, okay, right? Like a 4/4 across 2 bodies for 3, it's like, eh. Then draw card, 2/2 for 3, eh. You really probably want to do both. Yeah, seems pretty eh to me. Yeah, I think this card's a bit weak. Moon-Touched Amulet, you get 4 attack for 3, and if it's corrupt, you get 6 armor as well. This seems really good to me. Damage and armor, it's kind of like, it's not healing, right? So people used to be like, holy fire, wow, you know, 10 health swing. This is better than that. It's a 10 health swing, but armor's better than healing, right? That's a very nice card, very good card. I think we'll see a lot of this, because like the main issue Druids have, particularly in Duels, is their starting deck is a bit too slow. This is a good card to play in the early deck, and it'll scale very well if you get stuff like double spells. It's better than Bite. It's a lot better than Bite, in my opinion. Umbral Owl. Every spell reduces the cost by 1. It's a beast. Cards in your deck don't have decrease cost, so like if you played like 7 spells and this costs 0 in your deck, it doesn't cost 0. So if you're playing the what is it called, animal companions, shit, I forget what's it called, the thing that costs 8 that brings 2 beasts and gives them rush, yeah, so it won't get ruined by this card. It's all right, pretty decent. Fizzy Elemental, 9 for a 10-10 rush with taunt. And it's an elemental. Is that like beer? Is it like beer elemental? Cool. Yeah, it costs too much mana, but it's good. Like arena and stuff, I guess. Cenarion Ward, gain 8 armor, summon a random 8-cost minion. Doesn't seem that good, but the 8-cost minion slot has been pretty good over the years. So I actually think it's okay. It's just like, it's probably a card that you're going to be happy exists, but it's probably not a card you're going to put in your deck by yourself. Like, this is a card that you will want to pick up like late in a duels run, for example. You can double it with a 2-mana eclipse spell. Good call, good call. Still pretty mediocre. Greybow, okay, so this is a 5-cost 4-6 taunt, and the death rattle is give a random friendly minion death rattle, summon this guy again. So people said that this card is not going to be played and constructed. okay, I think it's going to be played and constructed, okay. I have a sneaky suspicion it's going to be played and constructed. The only way it's not played and constructed is if, like, every single deck is running nothing but silence, right? So, like, if this gets silenced, it's, like, not game-breaking, right? But, like, okay, like, what if it gets silenced? This is a 5-mana 4-6. It's not that bad, right? It's not that bad. It has taunt, so if you have any other card, they would have to remove the other minions with spells for this to not go off. If this didn't have taunt, it'd be way worse. Yeah, that card's insane. So Kiri, you get a solar and a lunar eclipse. It's a 4-cost 2-2, and you probably don't know what those are, but those are actually cards. Like, this is a card. This is not like the only way to get this thing. To get this thing is the other card? No, it's not. This is also a card. So this is really good, but you can also have these cards in your deck times two. So how good is Lunar Eclipse? Really good. Deal 3 damage. Your next spell this turn costs 2 less. So excellent stuff. Excellent. Excellent. I think it's better than Wrath. I think it's better than Wrath. And that says a lot, because I've not seen a deck without Wrath in a long time. Solar Eclipse, your next spell this turn casts twice. This is more of like a combo card. I think this card will see play, and I think it might see play even in duels. The main problem in duels with Druid is you just don't have like the balance of doing okay in the early game and then transitioning into a good late game. You typically have like too heavy of a deck and then start with like 2 losses, and that kind of sucks. But yeah, these are just very powerful cards. And obviously, Legendary that generates them both is really good. Draw a card. Guess if your next card costs more or less to draw it. So it's like draw 1, maybe 2 for 2. If you draw 2, it's really good. If you draw 1, it's just kind of okay. I think this card is pretty okay. I think some people will play it, but it's not that strong of a card. It's just card draw is always going to be considered. All right, next up we got Smorker cards, Huntar cards. Mystery winner. 1 for a 1/1. Battlecry, discover a secret. So you get a 1-drop, and you get a secret, which is a 2-drop. Super good. This card is going to be in basically every single Hunter deck. I don't think it's like game-breakingly good or whatever, but it's just like cards that do this are really good. Dancing Cobra, 2 for 1/5. The Corrupt gives it poisonous. So it is a really good card. It's basically infinity attack, 5 health. The problem is Corrupt means you're playing this after like turn 3 at least. So you're playing this on turn 4. Turn 4, 1/5 poisonous for 2. Yeah, I can see that. It's not as like game breaking as it looks, because like Corrupt stuff is typically better for like proactive cards like Taunt and Rush and shit like that. This is like a little bit weak. It's a beast, but it's still a very good card. New Hunter Secret. When your turn starts, if you control 2 minions, summon an animal companion. It seems pretty easy to have two minions if you're playing Hunter, especially in duels if you have the Death Rattle package. So the Death Rattle package is going to go really well with this. I think this is going to be in every starting Hunter duels deck. Trampling Rhino. So if you guys played this game called Magic the Gathering, they have this mechanic called Trample. This is what it does. And they named this card Trampling Rhino. So I guess it's kind of like a tribute to Magic the Gathering. Or someone really fucked up and QA is not going to be happy. Cool. It's a nice mechanic. I don't know if it's strong enough to see play, but it might be. Who knows? Jewel of N'Zoth. Summon three friendly Death Rattle minions that died this game. Seems pretty pricey for eight. Like, if this had like a white border and was a priest card, I'd be like, oh my god, right? Like, OMG. But it's a hunter card. So like first off, to play an 8 mana card, you have to be alive on turn 8. And your opponent must not be dead on turn 8. So like, yeah, that happens sometimes. But hunter is not particularly good at staying alive. And if they do go for the kill, turn 8 is like kind of slow sometimes, and you have to play Death Rattles. Yeah, it's like a really powerful card, but it seems like it's not gonna have a good fit. Rinlin's Rifle, 4 for a 2/2. After hero attacks, discover a secret and cast it, so you get 4 damage and 2 secrets for 4. It's a pretty good value. You're gonna see people play this weapon for sure. Don't Feed the Animals. Give beasts in your hand +1/+1. Corrupt +2/+2. Seems good. There's some real combo shenanigans, but again, it's more like very special case decks that would use this. I think this is not like a must craft or anything. Like, I think there might be some meme decks, and some of those meme decks might actually become really good. We'll see. But yeah, it's a tricky card to use. Probably not very used. Petting Zoo, however, is going to be very highly used. You get a 3/3. Okay. So some people think you get them based on each secret. No. You get a 3/3 even if you don't have a secret. Okay. So if you have no secrets, this is 3 mana 3/3 beast. That's really good. Okay. That's really good. Okay. No, that's actually pretty bad. But like, the fact that you get additional ones for each secret is insane. So if you have one secret, okay, you get 2 3/3s for 3. Which is ridiculous. If you have 2 secrets, you get 9/9 for 3. Like, wow. Okay, this card's really good. Darkmoon Tunk. 7 for an 8/5. When it dies, you do 4 missiles that do 2 damage each at random enemies. It's like not bad. No, my thinking is like, wouldn't you rather just play high main? And then if you have high main, would you play this with high main? It's like, I don't know. N'Zoth? Yeah, maybe N'Zoth. Maxima is good with that card, but I don't know if Maxima is good in general, so I don't know if that really matters all that much. So you get a card from your deck, it attacks the enemy hero, and then rips in peace. So it's pretty good if you have a lot of Death Rattles. Like, if you hit a Darkmoon Tonk, you're going to hit your opponent for 8 and then 4 missiles, which is really good. But, like, on average, I feel like that's not going to work out too well. All right, M-A-G-E. Cyclone. 2 for a 3/2, and you get 2/1/2 tokens. More importantly, every single part of this is an elemental. Keep that in mind. That's going to make this card crucial to some of the synergies that you're about to see. Crucial card. Very important. First secret you play each turn costs 1. Seems pretty decent if you're doing the secret thing. I don't know if you want to do the secret thing. We'll see. It's an elemental. 3 damage to a minion. And the corrupt hits it for 12 instead. So I guess if you're playing the whole elemental thing, this is probably worth using. Because if you're playing a slow mage deck, and you can play slow mage decks, you can play something over 5, and just like nuke something out of orbit if you're playing against a control deck. And if you're not playing against a control deck, yeah, 5 for 3/5, deal 3, and it's an elemental. That's pretty all right. This card seems pretty good to me. Mask of C'Thun, deal 10 damage, randomly split across all enemies. I think it's okay. It's a little bit too expensive, but I think it's okay. Some people might play it. This card's really good. This is part of the reason why you want some elementals in your deck. So you get 8/8 elemental for 8. Okay, but for every elemental you play last turn, you get another one. So, like, you don't have to fill your deck with elementals, because, okay, that was an 8-cost spell, right? Okay, so if you play the Confection Cyclone, and then you play the 2 1/2s, like, just this card, right? And then you play this thing the next turn, you get 4 8/8s just for that combo. Just for that, you get 4 8/8s. Yeah, that's insane! That's insane! So, yeah, that's pretty good. And this is an 8-cost spell, so you can save that other card for it. Yeah, Giant's Mage all over again, exactly. Transform spells in your deck into ones that cost 3 more. They keep their original mana cost. I don't know. I haven't really done the science on this. It seems to me like this would be pretty good. But, like... So, here's the problem. You have to have enough card drawn stuff, because like while your spells in general are gonna be better, it's gonna be crap like Summon a Beast from your deck. You know, it's gonna be crap like Mass Res. Yeah, it's gonna be crap like Avenge. Oh no, Avenge is what I'm talking about. But yeah, there's gonna be just cards. There's a lot of cards in this game that are good, but you have to make your deck built around them. Okay, so I don't know. I think on average this is good, but I don't know for sure. 6 for 5/5, draw a card, upgrade for each friendly secret that has triggered this game. The idea being that you draw a number of cards. Yeah, seems pretty alright, but again, you'll have to go pretty heavy on secrets to get the payout. I don't know if it's a good idea. If you control a secret, summon a copy of this. Cool, more secrets. If you didn't take any damage during your opponent's turn, draw 3 cards. Yep, this seems good. And so did that one Paladin secret that basically did this. Yep, no one played it. Not taking damage is actually kind of hard. Basically, you have to think of it this way. If you're up against a slow deck, you typically can afford to draw at just some point later on. You know, you're not in a rush. If you're against aggro, this just doesn't do anything most of the time. Yeah, so that's not good. Ring Toss, you get a secret. Corrupt, 2 secrets. To discover 1 secret, it's obviously terrible. To get 2 secrets seems pretty good. They're not secrets that you put in your deck, so I would count it as like 1.5 secrets, but it's 1.5 secrets on 1 card at like a half mana discount. Okay. Some good cards in there. The elemental thing works really well, I think. And the secret thing, we'll see. I don't know if there's enough there for secrets. Paladin, 2 for a 2/3, death rattle, draw dragon. And it's a Murloc. Wait, what the hell? When did this card get revealed? This card's insane. Holy shit. It's a death rattle to draw a dragon. You can even play this in duels if you have, like, big dragons, because your hero power will keep pulling these things out and keep drawing dragons. Yeah, you play Menagerie, which is dragons and murlocs. Wow, okay, that seems good. Snack Run. Discover a spell, restore health to your hero equal to its cost. Yeah, I can see that. Like, if Paladin players who play duels remember... You actually play garbage like Holy Light. You actually play that. And the reason you play that is because you really need some healing. Yeah. I think it's actually okay. When you summon a 1 health minion, give it +1/+2. Like, 1 health minions? But it's summon. Okay, summon includes your Paladin hero power. It also includes your duels paladin hero power because it actually gives it one health. So, yeah, cool. Could be good with tokens and stuff. I don't know. You'll see there's a number of things that Paladin's getting for dudes and tokens and stuff. So maybe the whole package will be good. Oh my Yogg, when your opponent casts a spell, instead they cast a random one of the same cost. Okay. This card is really good. Yeah, this card is really good. Imagine they try to play like Flame Strike and instead they like sprint, like mill or something. Like, it's so good. It's just so good. I believe recasting a spell, in general, I don't know, they may have coded this differently, but when you recast a spell, you typically get new targets for it. So it can be like, haha, I polymorph your Tyrion. And then it's like, nope. And then they like fireball their own face. Right? So, yeah, it's pretty good, I think. Is it demon for Paladin? For the rest of the game, after you summon a Silverhand recruit, give it Divine Shield. Seems pretty good, but obviously not for duels. Unless there is a new dude-based hero power. Who knows? We'll see. The other legendary. If your deck has no neutral cards, gain Rush, Lifesteal, Taunt, and Divine Shield. Yep. Seems pretty good. If you're doing that, pretty good. And some people are doing that. Balloon Merchant. Silverhand recruits get one attack and Divine Shield. This is not like a from now on. No, this is when you play this. So this is kind of like Quartermaster, basically. But it's much, much better statted than the Quartermaster. It's 4 for a 3/5. So honestly, if you hit one dude, it's probably good enough. So this should be a pretty played card in Constructed, I think. Carousel Griffin, 5 for a 5/5, Divine Shield. It's actually kind of good enough. And then if you corrupt it, it's an 8/8 Divine Shield with Taunt. What the hell? Yeah, this card seems really good. I think some players may consider putting this in their duels decks as well. Hammer the Naru. It's a 3/3 weapon. The battle cry gives you a 6/6 with Taunt. That's pretty good, I think. Yeah, pretty good. Some people play it. 3 Silverhand Recruits. The Corrupt summons 5. That's pretty strong. 3/1/1s is okay for 3. Not great, but it's okay. 5 is excellent. And with all the dude synergy that we saw, that is probably going to be a very important card in making that work. Alright. Priest. Excellent. Draw a minion. Corrupt reduces cost by 2. So it is a pretty decent card, but the idea is that you might be able to push for turns you otherwise wouldn't be able to perform. So, like, yeah, playing like, I don't know, like a Malagos and then casting some spells. That was a bad example, but you get the idea. So this is going to be a possible huge combo piece to Priest. The Fool. So this card doesn't seem that good, but actually it's really good. It has Taunt. 3/4/4/3 Taunt is not very good, but it's not terrible. The Corrupt gives you 4 health. So if you play like a Holy Nova and then you play this, it's a 3-cost 4/7 Taunt. Yikes. Yeah, that's really good. Really good. Goon the Blood God. Draw 2 cards. They cost health instead of mana. I don't know. You got to think about this one. In duels, it's really bad early, really good later. Because like in the late stage of duels, you have like 40 health or 45 health, maybe. I'm not sure. In Constructed, I don't know. Could be really good. Blood of Goon. 9 for 8/8. It is an elemental for whatever that means. End of your turn, you get a 5/5 copy of a minion in your deck. Very nice. It's kind of like Yashiraj, but it has Taunt, and it's a Priest card. Not bad. Idol of Yashiraj. Get a 10/10 copy of a minion in your deck, and you can get this one. Seems pretty good. Nazmani Bloodweaver. 3 for a 2-5, a good stat line. After you cast a spell, reduce the cost of a random card in your hand by 1. Card reduction, very good. Gahoon, oh yeah, right. Discover a spell, reduce the cost of spells in your hand by 1. And it has after the fact, so the spell that you discovered gets the cost reduction as well. So if you think about it, it's kind of like a bad, what was it, Primal Glyph or something? The mage card in like Ungaro that everyone played. If you have nothing else in your hand, it's a little bit worse than that. If you have like one other spell, it's about as good. Primordial Glyph. If you have like two other spells in your hand, this card is crazy, right? I imagine you can have that many spells on average. This card seems really fantastic. You get a 4 cost for 4. The Corrupt, you get a 7 cost. Corrupting a 4 is a bit hard. You have to play a 5 or more. This card might be a little bit too much on the slow side, I think. A little bit too much on the slow side. Nameless One. So, this card is really good because you silence something. Like, let's be real. If this card was 4 mana, 4-4, silence something, people would play it. That's how important silence has been lately. And that's how few options people have. And it's better than that. So, you basically choose a guy. This faceless is it. As a 4-4, so it overrides the stats, but then you silence his guy. So, yeah, that's fantastic. Every single priest deck will play this card, like, forever. It's just a better silence than other classes have. Fortune Teller, +1/+1 for each spell in your hand. I don't see people playing this, but who knows? If you're playing tons and tons of spells, why not, maybe? Alrighty. Rogue. Foxy Fraud. Your next combo costs 2 less. It's 2 for a 3-2. I think this is extremely good because there's combo cards that are, well, minions. So that's a massive tempo push. Actually, in general, combo cards are very high tempo to begin with. This is huge. Sweet Tooth, Corrupt, +2 attack and stealth. Seems a bit weak. Draw spell, combo, and a minion. So it's 2 to draw 2 if you have the combo. It's probably not the hardest combo in Rogue in general. 2 for draw 2 is very good. Having targeted draw is really important. If you're playing a deck with not many minions, you can perhaps do some really crazy shit with this. Or if you have a deck without too many spells, but good luck playing Rogue if you have no spells. Give your hero stealth for 1 turn. It's kind of like Ice Block. Actually, it is Ice Block in most cases. I have to imagine this card is pretty good. Shadow Clone, after a minion attacks your hero, summon a copy of it with stealth. So I think this card is very good primarily in duels because one of the ways that duels Rogue is played is by having ginormous weapons, stealth minions, and constantly going face. So if you play this, you're going to get a copy of your opponent's stuff to further go face. I think people will consider it, at least in this card pool, where if you have a few good secrets, you can even play Mad Scientist. Rogue Legendary Minion, return a friendly minion to your hand. It costs 1 this turn. I'm sure there's some crazy broken stuff that you can do. I haven't thought of it, but... at worst, it's a Youthful Brewmaster, and Rogues have used those in the past. Malevolent Strike, destroy a minion, cost 1 less for each card in your deck that didn't start there. Rip and Peace Assassinate, this is strictly a better Assassinate. If you have no other cards in your deck, if you have nothing else, it is an Assassinate, but it's new, which makes it better. So, Rip and Peace Assassinate. The other legendary, 6 for a 5-7, discover a card in your deck and draw all copies of it. The idea being that you're generally drawing at least 2. Because if you're discovering, you're given 3 options. If your deck is full of doubles to start with, you can probably just pick 1 option and get 2 out of it. So 6 mana, 5-7, draw 2. That's pretty alright. That's pretty alright. The idea is that there are ways to shuffle crap in your deck that are copies, and you can do some really crazy stuff there. Also, if you're playing duels or arena for that matter, you might have like five copies of something, which would make it significantly stronger. Ticketmaster, you get three tickets. When you draw, you get a 3-3. Eh, not bad. Prize Plunder is a pirate. The combo deals one damage to a minion for each other card you played this turn. So if you played like three cards and you play this, it deals three. Is that good? Yeah, it's not bad. It's not bad. All right, moving on to Shaman. Revolve is a big one. Transform all minions into ones of the same cost. So it's not evolve, it's not devolve necessarily. Everything. I think it's going to be played because silence effects are really premium. That's the only reason. 2-2 elemental, you get a weapon. Pretty nice. I think shamans and dual decks will run it. I think decks in general will run it. 3-1-2, you get a 3-2 duelist. The corrupt gives you two of them. Yeah, if you're playing... I don't think you'd play this in just any deck, but if you're playing, like, the Battlecry Quest Shaman, then yeah, right? Stormstrike is super good. 3 to a minion, and you get 3 attack this turn. It'll give you a double kill effect. Keep in mind, crap like Rockbiter, it costs 2 mana. So for 1 extra, you hit something for 3. That's, like, insane. Very nice card. Whack a Gnoll Hammer. 3-2 for 3. After your hero attacks, give a random friendly minion +1/+1. Pretty easy to have a minion because totems and stuff. Yeah. It's better than Fiery War Axe. Inara, on your turn, your hero has +2 attack and Wind Fury. This is crazy. So, like, if you can play this and have it survive one turn, you can probably just blow out your opponent. If you have a weapon already equipped, you can give it Wind Fury. So forget, like, having Doomhammer. Like, if you have a fully equipped Whack-a Gnoll Hammer, you can literally hit your opponent for 10 with it. Pretty good. Magic Fin. Ooh, what's this? When a Murloc dies, you get a random legendary minion to your hand. Okay. I mean, 3 mana, 3-4 is pretty good. You get a 3-2 duelist, and if your hero... has attacked this turn, you get another one. So, with some of the new weapon synergies, this seems like it's going to be a pretty effective card. And they did it, boys. Shamans actually got a legendary totem. At the end of your turn, +1/+1 to all other totems in your hand, deck, and battlefield. The idea is... I think you generally play this when you have a number of totems on the board, and that's it. And that's pretty decent. Like, if you have, like, 3 or 4 of the totems, like, +3/+3 or +4/+4, your opponents have to kill it. There are some new totem cards. Deal 4, corrupt 2 to all enemy minions as well. Super strong. So Shaman's getting some nice spells, but if you didn't notice, Shaman gets 0 overload cards. So they're going to have to get a new identity in duels. Because that's pretty rough. 1/5 taunt for 2. Not very good unless you have buffs, but you can get buffs for demons. Draw two minions. If they're both demons, reduce their cost by 2. So you can play a deck only with demons. And if you do, this literally is -1 mana cost. Draw 2 demons. That's pretty ridiculous. It's ridiculous. It's just straight ridiculous. That's broken. Give a friendly demon 3 attack and lifesteal this turn. And importantly, because again, this card exists, it is itself a demon. Wow. 6/6/4 taunt, death rattle, 2/3/2 imps. They're like, is that good? I don't know. Well, it's basically high main. It's a more aggressive high main that your opponent has to kill. And it's a demon. Wow. Destroy a random enemy. Corrupt, destroy 2. Corrupt again, destroy 3. 3 random enemy minions for 4. Wow. Cool. That's got to be good in control decks. Demon. 6/8/8 is the legendary. Remove the top 5 cards in your deck and the corrupt your opponent's deck instead. Oh my god, that card's crazy. What the hell? Okay, so like if you do the draw demon thing, this guy costs 4, and it's pretty easy to corrupt a 4-cost card, I'll tell you that. Okay, dude, Demon Warlock's exciting. Swap the cost and attack of all minions in your deck. So this is like if you want like a Malagos that costs 4 mana, if you want a Jiraxxus that costs 3 mana. I don't know if you can really make a whole deck with cards that are utilized with this that otherwise wouldn't suck. I think it's mostly a combo activator. But it could be a very good one at that, so don't think this card is bad. This card can be very good. Another demon, 4-4-4-3. Deal 2 damage to all minions, except demons! How about that? Demons. So many demons. Discard your lowest cost card. Give your minions +1/+1. So if you're playing Zoo, this might be pretty good. Pretty good. You can often target discard. Not a demon. Alert. This is not a demon. Even though, let's be honest, that shit looks like a demon. I think there's maybe a chance that this is a demon and the website didn't update it. But well, for now, it's not a demon anyway. 3-4-3-3, destroy a mana crystal for both players. So like Zoo and you want to like screw with your opponent. Yeah, it can be pretty good. Demon Warlock looks pretty insane, I will say. Warrior. Draw a rush minion, corrupt, +2/+1. So corrupt, again, if you're not paying attention, corrupt is you have to play a card that costs more than it to gain its effect permanently. So if this is in your hand and you play a 2-cost card, this will be corrupted. It'll be a brand new card. Okay. So corrupt is very easy to do on low-cost cards and quite hard to do on high-cost cards. So this is a 1-cost card. Basically, it's like, if you play anything else ever, it gets +2/+1. So that's pretty good. Bumper Car. Add 2/1/1 riders with Rush in your hand. Okay. It's a mech. It has Rush. And it's 2-for-1/3. It's pretty good. Minefield, 5 damage, split across all minions. For 2, I think that's pretty good. Stagehand, 2-for-3/2, random in your hand, +1/+1. I think it's not particularly that good, but there are a few reasons why Warrior want to play Menagerie, so you might want this just to have an extra mech. We'll talk about that in a second. Random taunt minion in your hand, +5/+5. I don't know about shit like this. Useless by itself, you need another taunt minion that you haven't played yet, and that card needs to not get, like, nuked out of orbit or silenced. Yeah, I don't know. I think this card's terrible. 4-for-2/5 with taunt, and it's a pirate. Again, pretty important that it's a pirate. We'll see in a second. Equip a 3-2 sword. Basically, you get a Fiery War Axe. So for 4, one more mana than a Fiery War Axe, you get a 2-5 taunted pirate. Holy shit. This card's insane. So if you're playing like a more control warrior type of thing and not menagerie stuff, we'll see in a second. It's just still a really good card. You get a weapon and a taunt. 5 health taunt and a weapon, right? Like control warriors, you need to have like a lot of value from the cards that you play, but you still need early game. This does that. Tent Trasher, 5-for-5/5 dragon, cost 1 less for each friendly minion with a unique minion type. So warrior has like a menagerie identity, and this is a dragon. A dragon is important in this case. I think this is pretty good. I think it might make the cut for the menagerie in this type of deck. After your hero attacks, give a mech. Remember mechs? Mechs are important. Dragon, like the last one. And pirate, like that one. In your hand, +1/+1. So, if you have all three of those, oh my god, right? Like, holy shit. It's a 2-cost weapon. It does 3 damage total. And you get +9/+9. What? Right, like, this is okay if you only have one of those. It's insane if you have two. And it's like, you're probably just going to win the game if you have all three. Ringmaster basically draws you those cards. 5-for-3/5, draw 3 specific cards. Very nice, very nice. You don't have to play as a menagerie deck. You might play as if you have some kind of crazy combo. And you might have that. After your rush minion attacks, deal 2 damage to the enemy hero. That's kind of a weird card. Sure, why not? can be okay. All right. Last ones. We got neutrals. I think there's a lot less neutrals than normal. I think this upcoming Dark Moon set is heavily focused on class cards, but we do get old gods. So there's not too many like filler trash neutral cards here. Safety Inspector is a 1-cost, 1/3. This stat line is played even with cards that have no abilities. The battle cry is shuffle the lowest cost card into your deck and draw a card. I think that is, in general, very good. In general. It might be bad in some decks. It's not going to be like this is in every deck. But I think this is going to make the cut in a lot of decks. Consumed Entertainer. It's not a Murloc. It's a dude in a Murloc costume, as you can see. You have a random minion in your hand, +2/+2. Meh. A 3/4. Yeah, still meh. I think it's meh. After you summon a rush minion, you give it +2 attack. But it's a 2-mana 2/3. It's a playable stat line. Looks pretty meh still. Both players draw a card, but it's a 2-mana 2/3 Murloc. Right? That's pretty good. That's pretty good. I think people will find a way to play this. Rock Rager. It costs 1 mana less than Magma Rager, and it has Taunt. But maybe Taunt is a bad thing, because if you play Magma Rager, you can play a Taunt in front of the Magma Rager to protect the Magma Rager, and then get that 5-fold damage for 3 mana, right? So the Taunt is potentially a bad thing, which is why it costs 2 instead of 3. It makes sense. It makes. You just got to think about it. It makes sense. Showstopper, 2/3, 3/2. Silence all minions, but it's a death rattle. 2/2/1, give adjacent minions +1/+1 on the battle cry. Not bad. 2 bananas to each player's hand. This can be good if you want to just like mill your opponent, I guess. 3/3/2 has divine shield, and if you corrupt it, it has rush as well. And it's a mech. I think this is a very good card. Particularly if you're pulling off some kind of menagerie thing, like a warrior deck or something. I like it. Dark Moon Statue. Your other minions have +1 attack, and the corrupt, this gains +4 attack. So this is okay if you can regularly corrupt it. But if you can regularly corrupt this and you're playing lots of small cards, you're only going to be able to do that easily if you're playing Paladin and your small cards are dudes. Otherwise, it's pretty shit. Play an elemental last turn, deal 3 damage. It's 3 damage to anything. So any deck that plays a number of elementals will play this card, because this card is insane, but you can't just play this card by itself. You need to have elementals in your deck. It looks like Mage is going to be doing that. Other classes, I don't know. 3/2/2, Battlecry, cast a secret from your deck. So it's not just tempo, you draw and play the card. Draw and play effects are very good. I think this card is going to be played, particularly if Secret Mage goes off. 3/4/4/4 with Taunt, the Battlecry adds a random 4-cost minion to your opponent's hand. Looks like there's going to be a lot more mill options, but we'll see. Amalgams are back. 4/4/4/5 Taunt with all minion types. This is pretty good. If you're playing like Menagerie Warrior, you're going to want this for sure. And if you're playing an Azothic in general, you're probably going to want that. Battlecry, restore 4 health. Corrupt, deal 4 damage instead. 4/4/3/4. If the corrupt effect is active, that is quite strong. If it's not active, it's probably not that strong. But the flexibility is interesting. I think it's a good card. 4/4/3/5, Wind Fury Elemental. Meh, probably no good. 4/4/3/4, Battlecry, deal 4 damage to each hero. I would say meh, probably no good. But I don't know, face decks might actually take a liking to that. 5/3/2, Battlecry gives you a 1/1 rider for each minion in your hand. They have rush, so. Yeah, that's pretty good. 9-cost, 4/4 with Taunt. The Battlecry summons 2 copies of this, and the Corrupt fills the board with copies. So obviously that's insane, right? But how do you corrupt this? You have to play a 10-cost card. A 10-cost card, guys. Yeah, that's really not easy to do. Right, that is really up there. Yikes. But even if you don't, I guess it's still pretty good, right? Still 12-12 and taunt. Yeah, it's not bad. It's not bad. Survival Druid. Yeah, Survival Druid probably play it. 6 for a 6/3. It has Rush and it has Death Rattle. Draw a minion and give it +3/+3. I think the fact that it has Death Rattle and Rush is fine. Combination is playable. It's a good card. Strongman. Corrupt. This costs 0. So, like, Ramp Druid's playing that card for sure. Optimistic Ogre. 50% chance to attack the correct enemy. Yes. It's not 50% chance to attack the wrong enemy. Glass is half full, guys. Yeah, no one's playing that shit. 2 for a 2/2. You gain +1/+1 on Corrupt, and it can corrupt all the time. So if this is in your hand and you play a 3-cost card, it gets +1/+1 permanently. So if you wait long enough, you can probably get this to, like, +20/+20 or something crazy as shit. If you can somehow reduce the cost of this, like, remember that Priest card, draw a minion, it costs 2 less. If you can land on this and then play, like, spell generation and stuff, you can probably get this to, like, a 100/100 or something. Darkmoon Rabbit. Rush Poisonous also damages the minions next to whomever this attacks. Cool, but it costs 10, so I don't know. C'Thun! Okay, this needs some explanation. Can you guys see this? Okay, no, you can't. All right, hold on. Okay, I'm gone. Okay, so you put C'Thun in your deck, all right? But then when the game starts, the C'Thun is not in your deck anymore. You get this shit, okay? So deal 7 damage, randomly split across all enemies for 5. That's pretty good. 3 damage to all minions for 5. That's pretty good. 6/6 taunt for 5. Yeah, that's pretty good. Destroy a minion for 5. Yeah, that's kind of shit. That's the taunt. Okay, so basically, you put C'Thun in your deck, he splits those 4 cards. You basically have a deck with 3 cards more than you started with, which might be really good if you're playing a card draw based deck in your duels deck. It might be really good. Here's the problem. After you draw and play every single one of those pieces, then you get C'Thun, this card, shuffled into your deck. You don't get it in your hand, guys. Okay. Because back in the deck. Yeah, that's a bit of a yikes for me. I kind of want to play it, but like, yeah, that's only for super slow decks. Yashiraj, the new one, the Defiler. 10 mana, 10/10, Battlecry, add a copy of each corrupted card you've played this game to your hand. They cost 0 this turn. It's pretty good, right? Pretty good. I think that's okay. I think that's okay. Play corrupt cards. Cool. Silith Darkwind's card's been out. You guys know that. There's like some OTK combos, giving them shit cards. Very, very cool card. Yogg-Saron. 10 mana, 7/5, Battlecry. If you cast 10 spells this game, spin the Wheel of Yogg-Saron. All right, let's see what we have on our list of prizes, boys. Mystery Box. Cast a random spell for every spell you've cast this game. Wow. It's like old Yogg. Fill your hand with random spells. They cost 0 this turn. Wow. Fill the board with random minions. Then give yours Rush. Okay. Take control of 3 random enemy minions. Holy shit. Okay. You don't get the... It's not Discover. You spin the wheel. Destroy all other minions. Gain their attack and health. Holy shit. All right, get... Okay, I'm going to need you guys to type POG, but not hit enter. You guys ready? Okay, so go to chat. Do P-O-G. Don't hit enter. Okay. The last option available. Cast Pyroblast randomly until a player dies. It's official, guys. The game is a meme. We just meme, guys. And keep in mind, this card is really good. Keep in mind, Hearthstone has a competitive scene. So people will probably play Yogg decks because they're going to be good on average. I want to see a world championship game end on the back of Rod of Roasting. Let's do it. Come on, guys. We can do it. All right. Nazoth, 10 for a 5-7. Resurrect a friendly minion for each minion type. So remember when I said like Amalgam is really good? Yeah, because like Amalgam is all. So Amalgam is like a tricycle type minion. So if it dies, it resurrects as under tricycle, okay? So wow, okay? I think that's going to be pretty good. It's a battle cry effect. It's not quite as strong as the old Nazoth, but I think it's pretty good. No, it doesn't keep all the buffs. Oh, I actually revealed this card right at the start. Rush, corrupt, +4/+4. Not too bad. All right, there you have it. That's the good stuff.